Owning a tandem is punk as fuck and not in any way peak middle age, although I suppose punk is peak middle age. Whatever. This frickin' head the ball's called Catherine. We are legally betrothed and I love her more than biscuits. We threw our loaded tandem on the train from London Victoria and jumped off at Bearstead in Kent, where I immediately stormed into a bougie butcher's run by these sexpots and demanded a massive pie. After 6 or so miles of getting banjaxed on nature's elixir, we encountered one rolling hill too many, so I gallantly stepped back and left Catherine to power us over the finish line. Go get 'em, tiger.
Trying to do the running man up the hill.
Yeah.
Our destination was well off the beaten path, which is great because we despise cruelty to paths. Our accommodation was this cool little pump house with a wood-fired hot tub, an outdoor shower and a compost bog. I'll go into detail in part two, but suffice it to say, it was a rural Elysium of flora, fauna and pheasant shit. You know, rustic but classy. Before long, we were larking around like a right pair of gibbons. Ooh, look, my wife. She ain't even on shrooms. Look, if you're too young to remember Little House on the Prairie, I can't help you, mate. I don't need to unleash my inner child, because I don't keep my inner child in restraints. If your inner child is leashed, frankly, that's a bit suspect. Why have you got a leash on your inner child, mate? What's it leashed to? A radiator in the basement of your decrepit soul, you monster. After a short but satisfying walk through a verdant patchwork of woodlands, meadows and glades, we end up in this quaint and agrestic, it's a word, Google it, country boozer. It had friendly staff and even a place to leave your depressed looking horse.
Yeah, mate, why the long face?
What? It's not like I'm getting paid for this. After a swift and refreshing lime and soda, I wasn't staring longingly at everybody else's booze, honest. We skipped back through the daisy lime fields like Julie Andrews on a speckled Mitzi and took no time at all to jump into this bad boy. I love a wood-fired hot tub, me, because I get to indulge my two main core pleasures of arson and floating about like a flatulent starfish. I find floating in water particularly restorative because it takes the edge off my autistic sensorial nonsense and helps me to emotionally regulate. That's right, I'm the Warren G of combating neurodivergent overwhelm. Warren G and Nate Dogg, anyone? No? I find me funny. Later that night, we went back to the Horse and Hatchet for some surprisingly tasty pub grub. And on the way home,
I'll see for yourself, who am I, Werner frickin' Herzog?
Pretty cute, though.
Donnerstag, 28.11. Hinter Volkertsheim Übernachtung in einem Strohstadel, weit und breit war sonst nichts, und so blieb ich, obwohl es erst 4:30 war.
Oi oi, let's check out these digs then. Listed on Airbnb as Wild Garden Retreat with Hot Tub, the property situated between Hooking, Frinningham and Bicknor, which to me sound like the kind of places that Bathsheba Everdeen might be stricken by the wobble pox. The pump house was set in the exceptionally well-kept grounds of a house so quintessentially English, the mere presence of my proletarian ass no doubt halved its value. The cabin itself is as cosy as a walrus in a flannel onesie, and thoughtfully put together by someone with an eye for design. Two eyes, probably. Not that Cyclopses shouldn't pursue careers in interior decor. Follow your dreams, kids, unless you dream about killing a Teletubby with a pickaxe. In which case, I don't know, eat less cheese before bedtime. I digress. Yeah, Catherine, that's not the door, mate.
Ta-da! So if I need the loo in the night, I could just go out that way.
Or,
oh, I wish I had
there's the door.
If you need the loo, you don't have to go out to the loo. You can just pee out the window.
Point is, there's lots of nice decorative touches, such as this decapitated Buddha and vandalised tea chest. And at night, the whole building is surrounded by pontoon and fairy lighting, which made me feel like the Disney princess I am. The mattress is up in this high nest, so if you have vertigo, then whatever you do, don't look down! Or I don't know, perform an impromptu labyrinthectomy or whatever. The wood-fired hot tub is double lush, and there's access to a communal barbecue. But a single batch of wood, kindling and firelighters comes to around 20 quid. So you've either got to have a kink for grilling, or like me, a deeply unhealthy attraction to setting fire to stuff. The compost toilet is well maintained, and even has a window, so you can stare down the squirrels whilst liberating your earthly burdens.
You want some, you donut?
There's an outdoor shower, so you can flash the badgers whilst abluting. There's a clean shared indoor shower in the back of the exceptionally well-kitted out communal kitchen. When I was 16, I got kicked off my YTS horticultural course for getting high on squidgy black and driving a lawn tractor over a rockery. Point is, I'm no gardener. Incapability brown, if you will. But even I could tell this place was special. Now, I used to be a little ghetto rat. Look at me now, getting all excitable about live willow weaving. Middle age comes for us all. Our little bit of garden even had this swing. Catherine wasn't a fan.
Getting in.
It looks horrible in there.
And this pond with a handmade bench so you can newt flicks and chill. Pun doesn't work at all, really. Shameful. The property also had these secluded shepherd huts, replete with their own hot tubs. So do I recommend it? Absolutely. Should you come and stay here? I don't know. Who am I? Your mum? You know, some joyless cynics call tandems divorce machines, but it's all about faith in each other. I have to trust that Catherine's peddling. She has to trust that I'm not going to go full-on quadrophenia and drive us off a cliff in a fit of amphetamine-fueled psychosis. Tandeming is the perfect metaphor for relationships. Both are about balance and compromise. Sometimes you grind each other's gears, but if you wobble, you correct and you keep moving forward. Teamwork makes the dream work. Or in the words of 16th century metaphysical scribe John Donne, synchronized peddling conquers everything. I believe that was from his little known slam poetry era. We headed out from the rural idyll of Ichnor on a supply run to Sittingbourne, which sounds all wind in the willows and afternoon cricket on the village green, but actually is a bit of a hole. To quote another poet, it was rife with fucking girls and fucking guys with fucking murder in their eyes. Sardonic twiglet-legged punk legend John Cooper Clarke could no doubt write an essay on the place, but I just wanted to scarper. I'm sorry if you live there and you love it, but as someone who was raised on a Preston council estate, I consider myself somewhat of a shithole connoisseur. And if this is the dump hill I've got to die on, so be it. In summary, the highlight was this bit of graffiti exploring Riley's complex relationship with morality and or hygiene. Sod the haters, stay golden, Riley. If arriving had been a rancid dumpster sandwich, leaving was a feast of relief and quaint Arcadian vistas, wheat fields and epic arable farms, topiarised hedgerows, and the kind of cycling that really floats my pedalo. Cycling through landscape like this is like free therapy, only it's cheaper, the views are better, and you don't have to prostrate your formative trauma in front of an apathetic shrink. Win. Before we had time to say parthenogenesis, we stumbled across this amazing anachronistic little summer fete in the charming village of Borden. The absolute state of these swivel-headed, saucer-eyed fluff balls. Steam engines! Shut up, maybe you're a nerd. Look at this lot, belting the bloody lungs out like absolute champs. We love this stuff, but I had to scarper before Catherine's prawns stank out the panniers, which is merely a statement of fact and not some sordid euphemism. A few more miles of idyllic, traffic-free country lane saw us back at our gaff on the Ichnor estate, where we set off to explore the surrounds on foot. Preeminent classical Greek physician Hippocrates famously stated that walking is man's best medicine, which is weirdly gender-specific. Sounds to me like the father of Western medicine doesn't pay his child support. Also, spurious advice that I wouldn't want to hear repeated on an oncology ward. Fortunately, we've made a stride or two in medicine since 300 BCE, and what can't be treated with medical-grade cocaine can be cured with organically farmed leeches, hand-reared on Gwyneth Paltrow's peaty bogland. The surrounding fields and meadows were a fertile cornucopia of farm animals and wildlife, including a profusion of butterflies like these pimped-out little dickheads. Ralph Waldo Emerson, who you may know as Chief Wiggum's son from The Simpsons, described a walk in the woods as a return to reason, which may be true for most. But despite being a highly educated professional, my wife can't step foot in a wooded area without having intrusive thoughts about witches and axe murderers. And despite being a literal adult human, I can't step foot in a wooded area with my wife without having intrusive thoughts about deliberately exacerbating her intrusive thoughts. What can I say? I'm a monster, just not as scary as the one that's hiding behind that tree. Not content with startling my wife, I started on the wildlife. I'm not a pheasant plucker, I'm a pheasant plucker's son, and I'm only plucking pheasants till the pheasant plucker comes. I was not expecting to nail that. Hey, someone call a fire brigade, it's a cat up a tree. Cat. Catherine. Up a tree. Doesn't really work. Look, I'm just a middle-aged man shouting into my iPhone, it can't all be comedy gold. There are those that fetishise arbitrary notions of maturity and would scoff at the idea of a 48-year-old man up a tree, but that's just the capitalist hunter trying to persuade you that audits and ices are more important than literal joy. Jesus, I sound like a Poundland Wolfie Smith. If there's anyone on TikTok old enough to get that reference, then you should probably have a little bit of a sit down. Give your knees a rest. After mucking around in the woods, we headed back and loaded up the hot tub with exciting flammables. I don't know, maybe fire ignites the darkness in my woeful soul. Or maybe I'm just an arsonist. Not content with blazing up the hot tub, I decided to get a Barbie going too. That's probably a bit excessive, innit? It's just such a mesmeric symphony of cleansing heat and redemptive light. I can't look away. Anyway, long story short, I completely incinerated Catherine's prawns, so we jumped in the hot tub and watched the sun sink like a pair of fish heads in a stargazy pie. That's some fancy reed weaving. Yep. I make all the grand observations. I'm like a sink estate Rousseau. Hey, don't be sad that it's over. Be glad that it happened. Unless, of course, we're talking about passing a golf ball-sized kidney stone through your urethra. But why would you even bring that up, you weirdo? Point is, our tandem ride through the scenic hills of Kent was coming to an end. So we decided to take National Cycle Route 1 to the historic town of Faversham. Unfortunately, rejoining the cycle network took us back through the municipal litter tray of Sittingbourne, where despite being on a tandem with my literal wife, these two urbane savants heckled us with anachronistic homophobic slurs. Now, in the defence, my hat does have a little bit of pink on it, and it must be hard containing all that bigotry in such a dearth of withered and sedentary brain cells. Poor little poppets. Leaving Sittingbourne was vaguely akin to exiting a day three festival portaloo. And in no time at all, we found ourselves gliding through the scenic expanse of the Kent countryside. So it didn't take long for Catherine to go full Doolittle.
Hiya.
Listen, I'm no Dr. Raj Persaud, in that I'm not a qualified mental health professional, and I prefer shoplifting to plagiarism. But I don't think it's controversial to say that spending regular time in the serene embrace of the countryside will have a positive effect on any disagreeable brain wonk you might be suffering. It's very hard to doom scroll when you're navigating a gravel bike path. And if, like me, you're ADHD, no rhyme intended, and you'd rather shove wasps down your Y fronts than engage in repetitive exercise, it's a fun and distracting way of staying fit. There's probably a joke about Big Pharma to be made at this point, but I really haven't got the spoons. So what can I say? It's been a lovely trip. And we finished our little sojourn to the Kent Downs by smoking DMT with some Hells Angels before twacking a Range Rover and ram raiding a footlocker. I'm kidding. We had a pootle around the antiques market in Faversham, followed by a lovely slice of cake. Who even am I? Faversham, by the way, is a surprisingly pretty little town given that it was built on the back of the munitions and explosives industry. So all in all, the Kent Downs are very lovely, with the exception of Sittingbourne, which I reiterate is an unwashed armpit. So that's all from Kent. If you're enjoying these videos, then smash that subscribe. I'm kidding, I don't care.